During a consultative meeting organized at Parliament over the proposed Public Finance Management Amendment Bill 2023, Peter Watua, a researcher with Accord, submitted that the Minister of Finance has too much powers on negotiation of loans and it must be trimmed to curb fiscal indiscipline.
I feel that the Public Finance Management Act gives the Minister a lot of power, and yet the parliamentary oversight comes in at the end of the borrowing. So what we want to advance here is that the minister goes into negotiations, gets these deals or whatever it is to borrow, then preempts parliament to approve that which he has already negotiated. We feel that in itself is tending towards fiscal indiscipline.
This comes after the opposition attempted to halt the approval of the 3.5 trillion shilling supplementary budget, where the Minister of Finance indicated that 3.1 trillion shillings meant to finance the supplementary estimates was going to be borrowed from local commercial banks, something the opposition argued that it's a violation of the rules and the Public Finance Management Act.
I feel that Section 25.3b leaves a lot of room, leaves borrowing on the table as an unfettered option to finance supplementary budgets. But there is a need for safeguards, because as a code we are very aware of the fiscal policy of Uganda.
Chivumbi noted that the objective of amending the Public Finance Management Act of 2015 is geared towards prescribing the conditions for approving supplementary estimates by Parliament and harmonized provisions related to the supplementary estimates.
Look at our supplementaries. They are almost permanent resident items in a supplementary. In every supplementary, you find their preside, banana initiative, TIC, Electromax, you know, all of them. They're almost, so if they are that a permanent feature and classified, then they are foreseeable. So then you can regularize them in the number. The question is, under a normal scrutiny of parliament, those expenditures will not be approved. So they hide under 3%, bring them as a postmortem.
The experts also welcome the proposal to protect the contingency fund from being used to fund the supplementary budget, saying it must be reserved for natural disasters alone.
The contingencies fund has to be protected. We appreciate the amendment of Section 26 as is being moved by the bill, insofar as it protects interference with this fund. This fund should be sacrosanct, well replenished, but unfortunately, as a board, we have observed that it's depleted.
Watua also raised concerns over the high appetite for supplementary budgets by government, with a study showing that for the last five financial years, in nominal amounts, the total supplementary expenditure approved by Parliament has been increasing up to 260%.
As a court, that the bill, in as much as it's a noble move, does not necessarily nip supplementary budgets in the bud. What do we mean? We mean that there are so many other issues that have been left out. We have not been satisfied by the bill insofar as the borrowing part to finance the supplementary budgets. We feel there is still a lot to be done.
Because the other risk we have, when you look at the public order, Public Finance Management Act, there are so many other aspects that need amendment. So if they are so comprehensive, could you move them as a private member? Therefore, you would need government to move that amendment, the executive to move that amendment, because they will definitely have financial implications.
Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.